Welcome back to the robotics lab at Lawrence Tech. I'm Jim, and this will be a very short video on using the right-hand rules or conventions for defining the positive direction of X, Y, and Z axes, and for determining the direction of a moment using the right-hand rules. Let's start with the axes. If we draw the typical X, Y, two-dimensional axis, the convention is draw the positive X to the right, the positive Y upwards, and if this for three dimensions, the Z would be coming out and poking you in the eye. We can use the right-hand rule to figure out which way is positive in three dimensions by using our thumb, first finger, and middle finger for the X, Y, and Z axes respectively. So in our two-dimensional case, my middle finger is pointing outward from the board, and that's the direction of the positive Z axis. I can draw the axes on the board in our more typical three-dimensional orientation. And if I twist my hand around, my fingers match the positive direction on the board. Ah, I got to get like that. Okay, so this is the downside of this rule. You have to twist around in a really awkward way to match the way it's typically drawn. But to figure out the positive directions for axes oriented differently, it's pretty easy to use. Just remember it's dark counting with your thumb, okay? Once we've determined the positive direction for the axis, we can use another right-hand rule to visualize the direction of a moment. Recall that the magnitude of the moment is equal to the perpendicular distance between our axes here and the line of our force times that force, okay? So when I turn my fingers in the direction of the applied moment, my thumb points in the positive Z direction, so I know I have a positive Z moment here. Or if we applied a force in the negative Y direction against some point on the positive Z axis, we'd be twisting it around the Z like this, or we would turn our hand this way, and we'd find that our moment is in the negative Z direction. Of course, we could be applying a force in any direction about any arbitrary axis, and the right-hand rule would tell us the resulting X, Y, and Z components. Some may be positive and some may be negative. So if I have an axis pointed this way, up and to the right and into the board, okay, if I apply a moment about this inclined axis, my thumb points in the positive Z direction, the positive Y direction, and the negative X direction. So this rule makes it simple to determine the directions of the I, J, and K components of a moment. So for axis directions, thumb, first finger, middle finger point in the positive X, Y, and Z directions. And for the moments, you curl your fingers in the direction you're twisting your system, and your thumb will point in the direction of the moment. But of course, as I said before, if you use your right hand. If you're writing, you have to put your pen down and use your right hand. Because if you use your left hand, just because it's empty, you get the wrong answer. And this is where left-handed people have the advantage on exams. I hope that was clear. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the flip side.